episode. We'll be right back. guys take some serious fucking ass. All right, let's hear it for Obituary. All right, coming up in just a moment or two, we've got American Eagle.
The Madman from Canada.
Okay, we're here with Obituary. Who are you?
James.
Guitar.
Frank. Bass.
Okay, cool.
So, how do you like New York?
Oh, that's pretty
fucking
cool.
Killer. Yeah. Fucking killer. Fucking killer. Yeah. I was born here, so.
Oh, yeah?
I know, it's fun.
Yeah, this is a cool show, definitely.
Cool.
How's the tour been so far?
The tour's been awesome.
Killer.
Yeah.
You should take it right to it's really good, man.
Yeah,
and
no
fourth
doubt.
Entry, you're killer.
Yeah, they're totally, everyone's cool in the whole tour, so it's going really good. It's going smooth, like, you know, between everybody. And plus, the turnouts and the responses are great. Like, usually even, like, better than tonight.
How come you didn't bring your stage effects?
We weren't allowed to.
We're an opening act, you know, we can't really have the god stage show. And,
yeah, we don't. We have, you know, very limited time, and plus other people's equipment set up on stage, and it's kind of rude to, like, set off flames because it produces a... Like the gunpowder resin would get on other people's equipment, and it's just, you know, it's not cool. It's sticky and shit. You gotta wipe it off.
But it's cool. You know, we'll be back headlining.
Yeah.
Bring it off.
Do the crowds in Florida expect that? The stage show?
I guess the people who are, you know,
Florida, yeah.
Used to seeing the Obituary.
Yeah. Been doing it since we were like 15 years old, you know. Every show in Florida is pyro.
Totally. Yeah. We did it right before we left on the tour. Oh, fuck. Right before we left on the tour, we played with Morbid Angel and Atheist, and we did full on flames and everything. It was great. 6 foot high flames shooting up in the air, and smoke. It was killer.
When's the album coming out?
That's September 12th. It's a killer, right?
I got one. Here it is. That's
cool. I was going to ask you about the cover.
Yeah, it's very awesome. Check it out.
Let's get that on tape.
Here, it spreads out. This is the incredible fucking expanding.
Oh, that's cool. Card.
Yeah, totally. With the, in case you fucking don't like the first picture, there's one on the other side.
Yeah, I heard the advance. It's great.
Shut up, cock.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah, man, sorry. I totally forgot that, dude.
Okay, do you think the tour would have been better for you if you were on tour with another death metal band rather than, like, a thrash band?
No, probably not, because, you know, death metal's, like, definitely on the rise, but it doesn't really draw the kinds of crowds that Sacred Reich can draw.
Yeah.
And, you know, so we're playing to a lot bigger crowds than if we just came out with another death metal band, and as a result, we're, like, winning over a lot of people, you know. We're definitely making new fans that are, you know, we're just... You know, turn on new people to death metal. That's what we, you know, we like doing. You know, we've seen it happen. Like, we didn't think we could do it. We were very skeptical about this whole tour, you know, and so were they. But it, like, blended together really well. Not like, you know, it's not like a lot of the same fans, really. I mean, it is a totally different type of music. But there is a certain amount of people that can, you know, that can dig our stuff too. And so that's totally cool to get in the play of big crowds right off the bat.
And like fucking Sacred Reich, you know, fucking huge.
Yeah, it's great exposure for us, which, you know, is just great exposure. Good exposure for death metal in general. It should help every band.
How many shows have you played outside Florida before the tour?
We played Mexico and Milwaukee Metal Fest.
Yeah,
this is the first, like, tour this band's ever gone on, so it's been going really cool, considering, no doubt.
Okay, you're probably going to get this question a lot. What happened with Death?
Yeah, I do get it a lot, quite a lot, like, usually more than, like, tonight. But basically, it just didn't work out for the best, you know, so we parted ways, you know, whatever, you know. I'm not the least bit bitter about it. I'm happy about it, you know. Hopefully they are, too, and so no one has to be bitter about it. It's cool, you know. I enjoyed playing Obituary much more.
What happened with Hellwitch, Frank?
Well, I don't know. I just can't get along with Pat, really, I guess, while I was in the band, you know. But now I get along with him now, perfect. You know, I mean, I'm a good friend still. It's just, I don't know, we just kind of clash, you know. kind of clashed, I guess, our personalities being together all the time, and there's like no way I could ever tour with that dude, so.
Right. So how'd you end up in Obituary?
Well, I was in Hellwitch, and I went and saw Obituary with Pat at this show at the garage. A whole bunch of bands, and Obituary played. And there's this big fat dude named Moose playing, and I knew right away he wasn't, you know, in the band or anything. So I talked to John, and one thing led to another, and I tried out, and they accepted me, so now I'm in Obituary.
Do you guys get along with other local bands in your area, like Morbid Angel?
Yeah, Atheist. I mean, they should say shit about us, but that's not our style. They can say what they want. I still worship Morbid Angel. They're one of my favorite bands.
Right? Yeah.
And we get along real good with Atheist. You know, they're really good friends of ours, and ESI, they're really cool. You know?
Here's our dick drummer, by the way.
Yeah, we get along with pretty much every band. Right. We don't like, I don't know, it's like, why should you be at war with other bands? You know, we're all in the same type of music, you know?
Right, exactly.
Fucking, it's just gonna kill the death metal scene if every band fucking hates each other, you know?
Exactly.
So, you know, we try to be friendly with everybody we can, even if they do say shit about us, fuck them, you know, that's their prerogative. I'm still, you know, whatever.
How do you guys feel about all these death bands recording at the same studio?
I think it's killer, man. It's fucking giving Morrison a lot of exposure and giving Scott Burns a lot of work. Making him lots of money.
Yeah, he's a cool, very cool guy. He deserves, you know, to get, you know, a lot of credit for what he does. He's a little overworked right now because of all the bands coming there. I think it is definitely, like, coming to trend, but truthfully, though, it truly is the only quality studio in that area that's real, that, you know, that has someone who understands this type of music that can, that, you know, have a sympathetic ear towards it and help you come out with a good quality sounding tape, because, you know, there's a couple death metal bands that haven't recorded at Morrison, and, you know, their tapes just, you know, they sound like they were done by someone who's used to mixing country music, you know, it's not, you know. So it's really like, it is the smartest thing for someone to do if they're within driving distance, or if they have the money to, you know, to take the bus or something there to record. It's like in the Florida, anywhere in Florida, it's like about the wisest thing they could do.
How did you decide to do the Celtic Frost thing?
It's hard to answer, because seems like everybody knew we were going to do it when we didn't even know we were going to do it.
All right.
I don't know. We were already done basically for the day. You know, we did a few songs for the rhythm tracks, and we decided to call it quits. The band was just hanging out. We, you know, decided to waste a little time. We were jamming. And it's like Trevor started playing it, and I kicked in, and when we didn't know it, Scott kind of like hit record and was recording us doing it, so, you know, we didn't even know until we walked into the room. So he rewinded it and played it back and saw, you know, heard how good it was, and so we went ahead and redid it, had John put the vocals to it, and it's like, you know, we couldn't say no.
Yeah. Fucking a Kid God song, it's like one of our main influences, you know, so why not?
You chose not to put Find the Arise on the first album. Why did you put it on this one?
I don't know, he knows.
You would know.
Well, for the first album, the only reason it wasn't on there is because Road Racer didn't want it on there. We wanted it on there. Road Racer wanted new material. We had like 9 songs done, and they wanted to drop Find Your Eyes and Like the Dead, and write. They wanted us to do 4 more new songs, so we did. If it wasn't for Road Racer, it would have been on the first album. I don't really know the reason why we redid it, besides it being one of our favorite songs, and it never really got pressed on the vinyl, besides, you know, the compilation album.
Yeah, it sounds a lot heavier now, too.
Yeah,
a lot better production on it.
Yeah,
for sure.
How did
Four more after tonight,
yeah. We got, like, tomorrow night, Columbus, Ohio. Then we got New Jersey, Morgantown, New Jersey, I think it's Morgantown. We got Brandywine, Maryland, and we have Nashville, Tennessee. And unfortunately, we had to like cancel the last 3 dates of this tour, which were Memphis, Tennessee, Huntsville, Alabama, and Atlanta, Georgia. And, you know, we're really sorry for everyone who was looking forward to coming to the show, or who had a ticket already to see us. You know, so it was like totally necessary, because we had a European tour booked before this one was booked, and the startup date was August 30th, and we found out that our flights left August 27th, and so if we would have played Atlanta, all the way up to Atlanta, which was originally the last date of this U.S. tour, that would have been like 25th, and then we would have been home at the 26th, and then we had to fly out the end of the 27th, and it was just like, we didn't have time to prepare to go to Europe. It's going to take us about 3 to 4 days to get ready to go to Europe, you know, to get all our things together. So we absolutely had to cancel them just to have the time to
be able to make the plane. So sorry to everyone, and we're going to try to make those places like a priority the next time we come around.
Who are you touring?
Especially Atlanta, because we really want to play there back.
Who are you touring with?
Morgoth and Demolition Hammer. Morgoth being here.
Yeah, Morgoth are awesome. Yeah. So is Demolition Hammer.
Yeah, fuck
like
yeah.
Morgoth are a total of them.
Yeah, we're totally lucking out. Like, we get this Sacred Rite, you know, forced entry tour, which is fucking god, and now we're getting a Morgoth Demolition Hammer tour, which is fucking killer. Yeah.
When are you playing Germany?
Right off the bat, August 30th, and it's like 17 dates or something in Germany, something like that. Like, a hellish amount of dates in Germany.
So I'm leaving September 12th in Germany.
Killer, yeah, we'll be there. We'll be playing in Germany then, still.
Great. So, who influences your band? Typical general question.
Whole band in general, each member?
In general, the whole band.
Like Celtic Frost,
mm-hmm.
Death, Slayer, Possessed, shit like that.
Do you guys individually listen to anything that isn't metal?
Yeah, fuck yeah. I listen to Soundgarden, Nirvana, and Chili Peppers, everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I listen to shit.
Primus.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah, I've been to Primus. I think they're pretty fucking cool. Right?
And a lot of hardcore, you know, Cro-Mags.
I like Ministry and Godflesh.
Yeah, Ministry is killer.
What do you guys think of Possessed reforming?
I think it's killer.
Yeah.
Is it gonna work?
Retain the fucking, you know, their style.
Well, it's only like one original member.
Yeah.
It probably isn't gonna be like totally like really similar, but you know,
it's
that's
still cool.
Cool.
Yeah, Mike Carrar is a god. Yeah. You know, fucking,
he's awesome. He's like writer. You know.
Yeah, he writes cool. So it'll be awesome, I'm sure.
Yeah, definitely.
Cool. Anything you want to say?
We'll wrap it up.
All right, I guess we'll wrap it up. All right, thanks for your time.
Yeah, thanks.
And look for Obituary.
Oh, God.
boys are us. Let's get this fucking place turned inside out. We'll be right back. Notes. This is our track off that single. Don't care.
Thank you.
should be out today. Entitled World Demise. It's the title track. This is how about that.
the wall.